But let's focus on the big story. The big deal that was announced between Tata Steel and the Swedish company Saab, that appears to have fallen through. We're getting comments coming in from the Saab CEO, and they indicate that, in fact, you know, that talks have hit a roadblock for a whole host of reasons, whether it's with regard to synergies. Earlier, it was reported that, you know, there were various other benefits that may not be realized. So on the back of that, the deal has fallen through. We have Amit Dixit of Edelweiss Institutional Equities who joins us on the phone line. Hi, Amit. Thanks so much for joining in. Just a quick question. Now that we understand that the deal has hit a roadblock, how much were you building in terms of, you know, a target price upgradation if this deal went through? And if it's not going through, how much are you going to be cutting?
No, hi. So, at the, I mean, we were not really building anything because we wanted to wait for the deal to be concluded before taking the affirmative on this. However, let me put it this way, for us, it was very clear the deal represented two things. One, of course, the valuation arbitrage that they would have got. Deal cycle is in a stage where you could have got much better valuation. So that is one. The point number two is, of course, the proceeds would have been used to visualize deleveraging. So that could have potentially led to re-rating of these. So currently, we don't have anything in our target price of okay. 7 rupees a share. But yeah, definitely, sentimentally, it's negative. Because if you look at it, the stock has very good run up, policy, steel cycle, some of the optimism that built the period of time because of this.
Okay, all right. Amit, I missed the target price. What is your current target price? And as you said, you were waiting for the deal to conclude. Only then would you be upping the target price. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. So a lot of people, you know, the street was totally divided in terms of what to take. In our sense was that the deal would have added around 30-35 rupees to our target price had it concluded. But so far, our target price of 750 rupees doesn't take into account anything from the deal.
Yeah, and so you're still positive on the stock. You have a target price of around 750 rupees. If the deal went through, your target price would have increased to around 785. So you were waiting for the deal to conclude. Couple of numbers then. If this deal went through, how much were you building in like that they would realize? 2.5-3 billion?
Yeah, so see, we were actually pegging it to the to what ArcelorMittal realized in this Cleveland Cliffs deal. Hmm. So we were building to the tune of around $2.3 billion.
2.3. Okay. All right. And now that that deleveraging, you know, it gets pushed forward. I think that was the big trigger out there, 2.5 billion going off their balance sheet. But at current reckoning, it appears that they're still making money on these European assets. So would you continue to remain positive? And I understand that just in the last 24 hours or there's been a price increase in Europe yet again, just when everyone is getting a little jittery about prices. So would you continue to remain positive out there, given that they're going to be making good money even on the European operations?
Well, yes, operationally, see, this deal would have made perfect. Operationally, companies doing very well. So, in fact, in Europe also, the spreads are good. Currently, you know, prices are good and things are going on well. So, operationally, of course, there is absolutely no issue. So, that's why I said that in terms of target price, we would have up the target price at the deal concluded. Yeah.
Okay. All right, Amit, thanks so much for joining in and giving us your quick take out there. So let's run you through. We had Amit on a bit of a scratchy line, but just to make our viewers understand, now the deal is unlikely to go through. What Amit is telling us is that his target price is at around 750 rupees and he was waiting for this deal to conclude. If the deal concluded, then he would be increasing his target price from around 750 to around 785 rupees per share. The reason that he continues to remain positive on the stock is because steel prices remain elevated. They're still making money in terms of the European operations. But what is negative is that, in fact, you know, this deal doesn't go through, then he was building in around $2.3 billion of debt reduction, which will now not come about as soon as expected earlier. So the street was working with a number of around $2.5 to around $3 billion in terms of debt reduction. That gets pushed forward. And on the back of that, the stock is under some pressure. But just pull up a 1-month chart. A one-month chart will tell you the real picture in terms of Tata Steel. The stock was more than 700 rupees when these reports started creeping in, you know, that in fact the deal may not go through. And from around that 725 rupees odd, the stock has already seen a correction of close to around 20%. Make no mistake about it, it's being viewed negatively. The only saving grace is that current prices, you're still making money on the European business. So keep an eye out on that stock. Well, Ekta, that's about Tata Steel. Back to you.
Well, thanks, Nigel, for taking us through the impact of that deal being called off. But you never know, there could be some other suitors emerging simply because of the kind of prices, like you mentioned, that we are seeing in the European steel market. The stock down around 2.8% at this point in time. But now, before we take a break, it's time for our CNBC TV 18 budget quiz. Remember, it's the penultimate day of the budget quiz, and you can win prizes if you answer this question.